Good morning, this is Genie from Expat on Purpose. My goodness, it is becoming so interesting doing the research that we're doing on our journey to moving abroad. And I've got to tell you that we are having loads of fun in the process, and I'm hoping that everyone watching with us likes the videos and that you will subscribe and share it with your friends and family. So what are we busy with now? We've spoken in one of the previous videos about the pros and cons and deal breakers, things that you're just 100% not going to accept when you move to a new country, and that you've got to make sure that the country that you're moving to is in alignment with your values and the things that you really want. So I've spoken at length about my challenges when we moved to Singapore. And the funny thing is, Singapore is English, but they still speak a lot of Mandarin. I found that it was difficult with the schools, the kids in the schools. Every day I would get there and the kids would not be interacting because of Chinese spoken instead of English. So what I've decided to do is I had gone and done research also on inquiry from one of the people that spoke to me and said they are looking for a country where the official language is English. I understand from people that I spoke to and expats that I've had communication with over the past 2 months that the language has got certain limitations, and I'm going to tell you what are some of the limitations. Number one, if you want to do a contract, whether it's for your house, whether it's for work, whether it's for business, and you do not speak the language, that is a big problem. All right, so what happens in a case like that is you're going to have to get an interpreter. The interpreter might not understand you, you know, when you start communicating with them. So sometimes it takes up to 2 or 3 tries or different interpreters before you've got the right person that's got to go with you, take your hand and go to all these places. We're talking about basic services like getting your license, and shopping. Yes, we all have Google on our phones and we can do Google searches and do Google Translate, but Google Translate also takes you only up to a certain point. Banking, for instance, if you look at a place like Panama, you have to take someone with you that speaks the language, and or even your lawyer that is, you know, lingual and can speak the language that is Spanish, like Panama is. So there's a lot of things that you've got to take into consideration, and I feel that families with children moving abroad, I think that could really become a big thing. So for us, and I might, you know, be one of few that have decided that English has to be the main language or the predominant language spoken. So I have compiled this list and I'd like you to have a look. After you've seen that, you would have seen that there is Africa. We're talking about Africa has got quite a few places that whose official language is English. Then we've spoken about Asia and Oceania. I don't think I'm going to embark on any of those right now. Then we've got all of South America, Central America, and the Caribbean, which is extremely interested in those countries and looking at an option purely because of the weather and the close proximity to where the kids want to go when they go to university. And then the obvious ones is North America, Canada, obviously barring Quebec, because Quebec is French. And then you're looking at England, Ireland, those areas. So where is it that you would like to go? If you had to choose a country, is language important to you? I'd like to hear from you. How did you experience it if you are already overseas? Was the language really a barrier, or is it just a matter of getting used to it? Right, folks, I'm looking forward to you following me and interacting with me. I'd like to hear from you and what your thoughts are. Maybe you've got some questions for me. I'm very happy to answer anything that I can answer. Remember, I'm not an immigration lawyer, and I'm doing this to help people that wants to move abroad to make the right decisions, because it's a costly affair and you want to make sure that you do the right thing.